Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning, everyone, students. Selamat pagi. Meskipun sekarang hari siang, tapi semangat masih seperti semangat pagi. Welcome back to our online class. Today it is our fourth meeting in academic and professional speaking online class. Jurusan Tadris Bahasa Inggris, Universitas Islam Negeri Imam Bonjol, Padang. Nice to see you again. Without further ado, because we are having online class, so we need to spend and use our time wisely, I'd like to go on with the presentation. So our topic today is about this one. Can you see the slide?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. All right. Good. So the academic and professional speaking class for the fourth meeting, pertemuan keempat, kita akan membahas topiknya tentang types of speaking skills in academic context. Nah, ini sesuai dengan silabus yang saya berikan di pertemuan pertama kita ya, di introduction. Types of speaking skills in academic setting. It's going to be a very long explanation karena ini cukup teoretis dan cukup panjang penjelasannya, jadi please bear with me. I'm going to use English and Bahasa Indonesia interchangeably, ganti-gantian. If you have question or you have something in your mind that you want to ask, just ask or type your question in the chat column. Atau boleh tanyakan di bagian chatting. Okay, so I'd like to continue to the next slide. So we start from here. We know that English-speaking countries, I took it from the internet sources from Microsoft. So,
halo.
Siapa itu? Fahru Rozi, ya? Okay. All right. So, now I'd like to go on with this. Please turn off the audio for a while. Five branches of world English. In English-speaking countries, we start from here. We have ada Canada, the US, and then we have British Islands. And we also have South Asia, Philippines, Southeast Asia, East Africa, South Africa, Australia, New Zealand. Nah, ini semua yang berwarna ini menggunakan bahasa Inggris. Five branches of world English. Jadi ada lima cabang bahasa Inggris di dunia. Pertama ini American English. Ini especially ada di Canada. Dan juga American English ada di US dan Canada. Mostly ya. Kebanyakan mereka American English ditemukan di sini. And then we have British English. British English and British English. Variasinya yaitu di negara-negara ini. Filipina, Papua New Guinea, Australia ternyata menggunakan British English. Karena mereka bagian dari Commonwealth country, British English. And we have Southeast Asia, ini British English juga, ya ternyata ini British English. You can use American English or British English. It depends on how you want to use that. So dari sini kita akan beranjak masuk ke topik berikutnya, bahwa di dalam bahasa Inggris ada British, ada American, dan ada ekspektasi nanti di dalam academic and professional speaking. Nah, kita lihat slide berikutnya. Ini, it says that we go on with this. So we have, I take it from Cambridge University Press with the title English for Academic Purposes, EAP. Ini ada buku, A Guide and Resource Book for Teachers, untuk guru-guru. Ini saya ambil dari tulisan Jordan. Ini penulisnya R.R. Jordan. Penerbitnya adalah Cambridge University Press. Ini adalah DOI. Pernah dengar DOI? DOI? Pernah dengar?
Pernah.
Pernah ya. Jadi sering ya, kalau DOI ini kalau kalian mendownload Juna artikel selalu punya ini DOI, yaitu Digital Object Identifier. Okay. So in this book I found it online, halaman 193 sampai 207, bab ke-13 berjudul Speaking for Academic Purposes. Jadi kita spesifikkan speaking, tapi speaking kita ke tujuan akademik dan tujuan profesional. Jadi bukan speaking di cafe, di kantin, bukan ya. So this is academic and professional. So what is it? According to R.R. Jordan di Cambridge University Press mengatakan bahwa speaking for academic purposes is an overall term used to describe spoken language in various academic settings. Ini dia. To describe spoken language. Jadi spoken language in various academic setting. In addition, it suggests that the language used is normally formal or neutral and obeys the convention associated with the genre or activity. Katanya berkaitan dengan bahasa yang digunakan pada umumnya berkaitan dalam bentuk formal atau netral dan mengikuti konvensi yang berhubungan dengan genre atau aktivitas tertentu. Typically, situation or activities covered are yang termasuk ke dalam speaking for academic purpose, pertama ini, asking question in lectures. Seperti misalnya ketika kalian bertanya ke saya, berarti yang digunakan adalah academic English, academic speaking. Bukan cara bertanya begini, Mister, you know what? I want to ask you a question. Why did you deny? Itu bukan academic. It should be academic. Asking question, participation in seminars or discussions, making oral presentation. Nih, yang saya lakukan sekarang ini disebut dengan oral presentation. Nanti ketika kalian kompre atau munakosa, then you have to present your research, that would be called as oral presentation. And then answering question or point. Nanti kita akan menerima pertanyaan dari pendengar. Yang terakhir, verbalizing data and giving oral instruction in seminars, workshop, or laboratories. Because you're going to be a teacher, karena kalian akan mendapat gelar sarjana pendidikan di bidang bahasa Inggris, maka ini penting, kemampuan speaking for academic purposes. Your English will be different from people in general because you're going to use English for academic purposes in any kinds of languages. Next one, apa saja academic skills to prepare your students for higher education nih, untuk perguruan tinggi ya. Jadi kita melihat konteksnya di perguruan tinggi, apa-apa saja yang diperlukan. Katanya begini, hold on. Why are academic skills important? Kita mulai dulu dari pertanyaan. Oh ya, ini saya ambil dari Pearson. Pearson yang cukup terkenal secara internasional, Pearson Education. Why are academic skills important? Kenapa penting? Karena academic skills encourage students to become more efficient learners. They give students the confidence to participate fully in English speaking courses and are invaluable outside of the classroom and after they graduate. These skills, which include critical thinking and note-taking, are also highly transferable and therefore vital for success in any career. Ini katanya ini, menurut Pearson, Richard Cliff, tanggal 22 Oktober 2018, penting karena sangat bermanfaat bagi mahasiswa, bagi pelajar. Tidak hanya berpartisipasi secara penuh dalam pelajaran bahasa Inggris, tapi juga bermanfaat untuk di kelas serta setelah wisuda nanti. Students are expected to have a number of these skills when they start in higher education. The Global Scale of English, or GSE, Teacher Toolkit organizes them into 5 categories. First, academic discourse, skills for communicating effectively in debates, discussions, and presentation. Ini yang penting. Ini kita akan belajar ini nih, academic discourse. Yang kedua, academic text strategies, skills for analyzing academic text in greater detail. Ini strategi bagaimana kita menganalisa teks secara akademik. Ini kalian lakukan nanti ketika menulis skripsi bab kedua, tinjauan kepustakaan atau review of related literature. Yang ketiga, academic strategies, skills for understanding and responding critically to lecturers. Yang keempat, composition, skills for effective academic writing. Ini juga penting. Kenapa? Karena salah satu bukti ketika kalian akan menerima gelar sarjana, 50% bobotnya berada pada skripsi. Makanya ada ini, academic writing. Yang kelima, comprehension, skills for understanding academic texts and lectures. Itu sebabnya ada namanya ujian skripsi, kemudian ada monokoso, ada kompre. Karena ujian-ujian tersebut akan digunakan sebagai cerminan bagi kalian sejauh mana ilmu yang telah dipelajari, telah dikuasai sebagai calon sarjana. So, this is very important for you, academic skills. Jadi, ini skill yang berbau akademik. Ya. Nah, kemudian kita lihat berikutnya di sini. Wow, it's very long. Ini contohnya ini. Ketika saya suruh baca ini, siapa yang mau baca? Silakan. Ini dari University of Minnesota di Amerika Serikat, Driven to Discover. Di dalam website mereka ada ini, Speaking in Academic Settings. Anyone wants to read this? Satu orang lah. One woman, okay, Eno Permata Aura, and yang satu lagi, yang laki-laki lah, siapa mau? Siapa? Eno, satu lagi? Nggak mau. Pak Rozi mana dia? Aditya. Arisco Aditya Pangestu. Mana Arisco? Coba wajahnya Arisco, I cannot see you. Nah, ini kalau bisa begini nih, dibiarkan videonya nongol, kita pergi yang lain, tempat lain. Coba Arisco Aditya, mana Arisco Aditya Pangestu? Ulianya udah ini, udah nunggu-nunggu lama. Si Ulia. Oke, kita coba selain Eno lah yang mau, perempuan. Kalau laki-laki nggak ada, perempuan maju. Pak Rozi.
Kalau patah-patah nggak apa-apa, Pak.
Patah-patah nanti kita lurusin. Pak Rozi, berarti... Baik, pertama nanti Isyadatul ya, Isyadatul Ardi. Kita coba Eno, silakan Eno yang dari oral, sorry, balik. Nah, dari oral sampai ke classes, silakan.
Okay, sir. Oral communication has always been a part of higher education, and communication skills in general became more of a focus for college and university in the late part of the 20th century. As the first, communication across the curriculum programs began to develop. This program focuses on the importance of writing and speaking skills for the further academic, professional, and civic development. Your school may very well have a communication across the curriculum program that includes requirement for foundational speaking and writing skills that are then built on in later classes.
Okay, good. Thank you, Eno. The next one tadi siapa? Pak Rozi.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay, silakan.
Dari weather sampai habis, sir?
Yes.
Okay. Whether your school has a communication across the curriculum programs or not, it is important to know that the skill you develop in this class serve as a scaffold from which you can continue to build and develop speaking skills that are tailored to the needs of your particular... Sir, kursornya ketutupan, sir. Field of study. As you participate in oral communication within and about your field of study, you become socialized into the discipline-specific ways of communicating necessary to be successful in that field. This communicative process start in the classroom.
Okay, thank you, Farouk Razi. Yeah. All right. So the point is, kita sudah membaca bagian ini. Ini intinya adalah speaking in academic settings yang berkaitan dengan oral communication. So oral communication, mana dia? Okay. So it means that it leads to part of higher education, bagian dari pendidikan tinggi, and communication skills in general became more focused. Jadi bagian penting dari sekolah tinggi dan universitas-universitas yang dimaksud dengan communication across the curriculum. Jadi dia akademik. Yang kalian lihat bahasa Inggris di film, kemudian bahasa Inggris atau bahasa asing yang ada di lagu-lagu, itu semua tidak akademik. That is called as popular art of English. Academic can be found in academic textbooks or academic lectures. Nah, ini intinya ya. Jadi, Daniel said, as you participate in oral communication within and about your field of study, seketika kalian berpartisipasi secara komunikasi oral di dalam, baik dalam ataupun tentang studi Anda, misalnya sekarang tadi bahasa Inggris, you can study about tadi bahasa Inggris, or bahkan iseng-iseng baca buku kedokteran dalam bahasa Inggris, boleh. Karena ketika saya mahasiswa dulu, salah satu dosen saya, beliau sekarang sudah pensiun, beliau bilang begini, if you want to make English becomes part of your life, you have to make English run through your blood, jalan dari dalam darahmu, dengan cara membaca berbagai macam teks dalam bahasa Inggris. That's one thing. And second thing, try to communicate in English orally, directly. You become socialized into the discipline. Jadi, itu sebabnya kenapa universitas dikerucutkan menjadi fakultas, lalu jurusan-jurusan, kemudian program studi, dan kemudian kelas. Karena kita lebih spesifik pada disiplinnya ya. Nah, kita lanjutkan. Berikutnya adalah, okay. So this is the becoming a confident speaker from BBC World Service, Learning English. Ini materinya saya ambil dari sana. Better speaking, a guide to improving your spoken English. Jadi sebelumnya kita membahas pentingnya oral communication in the academic setting. Nah, sekarang kita lanjutkan yang dari BBC. Minggu lalu kita sudah membahas tentang becoming a confident speaker. Bagaimana menjadi pembicara yang confident. We have fluency or accuracy, finding the right words, learning language in chunks, showing where you are going, keeping the listener interested, being a supportive listener, and sounding natural. So we focus on fluency or accuracy. Jadi banyak orang bilang bahasa Inggrisnya lancar atau bahasa Inggrisnya tepat. Mana yang lebih bagus? Ada yang bilang, wow, bahasa Inggrisnya lancar atau bahasa Inggrisnya tepat. Dia pelan-pelan tapi tepat. Atau cus-cus. Nah, which one is better? Ada yang bilang, biarlah dia berbicara lambat tapi dia grammarnya tepat. Atau ada yang bilang bicaranya cepat tapi mudah dimengerti. So which one is better? We would like to see this. Nah, ini dia. Number two, fluency or accuracy. Can you see the text? Bisa dilihat teksnya di sini? Ya. Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, good. Nah, this is what it says. Speaking English fluently is a goal for many learners of English. Jadi kebanyakannya di seluruh dunia, ini ngomong ya, sih ya, katanya berbicara dengan bahasa Inggris secara lancar adalah tujuan banyak pelajar bahasa Inggris. Fluency means being able to communicate your ideas without having to stop and think too much about what you are saying. However, many learners also have the goal of spoken accuracy. Jadi yang dimaksud dengan fluency ini adalah seseorang yang berbicara dengan bahasa Inggris tanpa harus berpikir lagi apa yang dia bilang. Kalau ketika kita berbicara bahasa Inggris, sometimes you have to think about your vocabulary. You have to think about the grammar. If that is what you do, berarti you are doing this, speaking accurately. Tapi kalau dia cut, berarti itu adalah speaking fluency. fluency. Yeah? Nah, speaking accurately means that you speak without errors of grammar and vocabulary. Jadi mau lambat, okay, today I'm going to explain about many important lessons. Nah, itu adalah speaking accurately. Bagusnya adalah kedua-duanya ya. Which is more important and more difficult for you? Nah, kalian mana yang lebih penting dan lebih sulit? Fluency atau accuracy?
Fluency.
Karena fluency ini dia well, you know, something like, you know, itu fluency. Terkadang meskipun fluensinya ada, grammarnya juga ada yang salah, error. Nggak hanya kita, native juga kadang-kadang melakukan hal demikian. It might depend on how you have learned English in the past. Jadi katanya menurut BBC ini, itu tergantung dari bahasa Inggris yang kalian pelajari di masa lalu. Nah ini kita ambil contoh, here is Jinping from China, talking in better speaking. Yang dia berbicara in better speaking ini maksudnya dia berbicara secara bahasa Inggris yang lebih baik gitu dibandingkan ini ya. Dia bilang begini. I have learned English for almost 15 years. I have no problem with reading and listening, but speaking has always been a problem for me because when I was at school, we always focused on grammar, vocabulary and exams. Now, I really want to improve my spoken English to a new level to achieve that freedom in speaking in the near future. I would try anything to help me achieve this. Okay, itu cara saya membaca. Sekarang kita coba undang Imelda. Coba Imelda baca ini. Yang Xi Jinping tadi ini.
Yang mana, Chef?
Yang ini, I have learning. Apakah bisa dibaca?
Bentar. Kecil banget, Chef.
Oh, kecil. Oke, okay. Karena kecil nggak apa, kita lanjut aja. Atau Olfariza, siapa yang bisa melihat teksnya ini?
Saya, Sir.
Oke, silakan. Saya, Sir. Desri Nancy, coba.
Yang I have to answer dibaca.
Ya, betul.
I have learned English for almost 50 years. I have no problem with reading and listening, but speaking has always been a problem for me. Because when I was at school, we always focused on grammar, vocabulary, and exam. Now, I really want to improve my spoken English to a new level to achieve that freedom in speaking in the near future. I would try anything to help me achieve this.
Okay, thank you, Destri. Muncul pertanyaan dua buah. Question A, what does Jinping think is the cause of the problem? Do you agree? Problemnya ini, I have no problem. Tapi yang menjadi problem itu ternyata speaking. Speaking has always a problem for me because, katanya. Ya, because ketika saya di sekolah, kami selalu fokus kepada grammar, vocab, dan ujian-ujian. Yang di kita juga begitu nggak?
Yes.
Ya, yes, grammar, buku grammar setebal entahlah gitu loh kita belajar grammar. Tapi kemudian pas mau ngomong aja ingat, oh ya itu kan conjunction, oh ya itu gerund, ah lupa verbnya salah. Jadi akhirnya kalian nggak efektif berkomunikasi, berbicara ya. Jadi fokus kepada aplikasi penggunaan pemahaman grammar itu kepada writing. Kalau ke speaking nanti kalian fokus ke meaning yang mau disampaikan ya. Nah kemudian do you have the same problem? Oh ya, ketika saya usia kalian, I do experience the same thing. Ya. Nah, kita lanjutkan berikutnya ya. Nah, ini. Jadi pertanyaannya adalah, so which is more important, fluency or accuracy? If, like Jinping, jika seperti Jinping, you have a very strong focus on accuracy, on getting the grammar and vocabulary correct, you may find that you worry about making mistakes. Ya, jadi kalau seperti Jinping fokus kepada grammar saja dan vocabulary-nya, maka nanti ketika kalian berbicara dengan bahasa Inggris yang akan terjadi adalah selalu memikirkan grammar dan vocab. Jadi semacam ada yang memblokir. Nah, ini makanya terjawab ya pertanyaan yang sebelumnya yang bagaimana how to speak confidently gitu tanpa berpikir. Berarti yang bersangkutan speaking accuracy bukan speaking fluency. Kemudian this can make you shy from speaking in English and as a result your spoken fluency might not improve. Jadi akibatnya adalah kelancaran dalam berbicara tidak meningkat. This means that although you know English well, you might not be able to have a conversation. Jadi ada orang pendiam, dia sudah bisa bahasa Inggris lancar, tapi karena tidak punya fluency, dia akan cenderung seperti seperti kurang conversation. It's not going to be interesting. If you want to be a teacher of English, you need to be balanced between having speaking and communication. Jadi harus balance. On the other hand, you may be someone who really likes to talk. Atau di sisi lain, kamu mungkin menjadi seseorang yang benar-benar suka berbicara. And you are willing to try out language even though you make mistakes. Ada juga orang gitu. Biarlah salah deh. Oh, bodo amat. Yang penting gue ngomong. Ada orang seperti itu ya. This can help you sound very fluent. Nah, kalau itu sangat membantu kita terdengar seperti sangat lancar. However, if you make too many mistakes, which you do not stop to correct, kalau sering membuat kesalahan yang tidak mau diperbaiki, you can find that it's difficult to make others understand your ideas. Dan itu juga akan membuat orang lain sulit memahami apa ide Anda. Jadi, it should be balanced, ya. Fluency or accuracy. The next one, speaking a language well requires both fluency and accuracy. Jadi berbicara dengan bahasa Inggris harus gabungan keduanya, fluency dan accuracy. So how can you make sure that you develop both? Terus gimana cara mengembangkan kedua-duanya? Satu, identify your learning style. Identifikasi, kenali cara kita belajar. Nah, how do you learn? Do you keep silent or do you like to hear music or do you like to hear people or do you want people to hear you when you study, when you're learning? So that's the question. What kind of learner are you? Think about situation in which you have used English and how you felt about making mistakes. Is being correct when you speak the most important for you? Or do you always take risks trying out new language, even though it might not be correct? The first step towards improving your spoken English is recognizing what is easy for you, and then working on what is difficult. Jadi mana yang paling mudah dulu? Baru kita beranjak ke hal yang sulit. Kalau yang sulit, biasanya kalau untuk pelajaran Indonesia adalah accuracy. Fluensinya kita kejar dulu. You know what? You know, sometime I'm going to just say something, say word. Gitu ya. Nanti setelah lama-lama, nanti kita perbaikan accuracy-nya. Yang kedua, focus on one area at a time. Fokus pada satu hal di satu waktu. Jangan seperti gado-gado. Semua blok satu. Jadi cara berpikir kita pun jadi nggak jelas. Satu-satu, one by one. Ya. When you speak English, do you notice any mistakes which you make quite often? Maybe you make mistakes with tenses or with question forms, or do you sound slow, as if you are always searching for words and correct grammar? Next time you speak with your friends, try to work on the problem you have noticed. What is the problem that you notice? Maybe you want to talk about something that you don't know, or the verb, or the vocabularies. If it's fluency, try to focus on making sure your friend understands what you've said, not on avoiding mistakes. If you have a problem with tenses, try to correct yourself only when you make a tense error. Don't think about other mistakes. By choosing an area to work on, you can help yourself overcome problems. Jadi satu persatu, kalau misalnya ketemu, oh iya, dikoreksi sama temen nih, bukan. seharusnya bilang they went. Tadi bilang they would go, bukan they would go, they went. Oke. Satu-satu, tenses, kemudian modal, seperti itu ya, perlahan-lahan. Sama seperti kita belajar baca Al-Quran, yang qaf dengan ka itu bunyinya beda. Di awal-awal mungkin terkesan sama, tapi ternyata beda bunyinya ya. Yang ketiga, vary your practice, variasikan praktek berbicaranya. If you are a member of an English club or learning circle, make sure you vary the types of activities you do so that you get practice both in fluency and in accuracy. Ikut club-club conversation. Misalnya di kampus, ada nggak grup-grup atau kelompok-kelompok yang memfokuskan kepada conversation? Join with them. Don't shy away. Involve yourself. Because that's positive, right? There's nothing wrong with that if you join with them. And discussion are good fluency activities as long as you don't stop each time a mistake is made. Jadi diskusi itu boleh. Mau ke kantin, speak in English. Go to the mall, speak in English. Do something in English. Or you want to call your friend, use English. Toh bahasa Indonesia juga nggak akan hilang. Bahasa Minang juga nggak akan hilang. Just try to speak up. Atau misalnya, Assalamualaikum, I would like to talk with you about this. Atau misalnya kalau kalian mau curhat pakai bahasa Inggris. Itu juga boleh. That's a good idea. Jadi kalau misalnya mau ngomong-ngomong juga di teras misalnya kan, sesama cewek misalnya, toh nggak ada orang yang tahu kan apa yang diomongin. This for example, nggak apa-apa. Why not? Try to practice and use that. The next one, we will having this conversation. I took it from the book Fluent English, buku berjudul Fluent English, yang ditulis oleh Barbara Reif-Snyder, yang diedit oleh Christopher A. Warnost. Siapa yang mau baca ini? Yang mau menjadi Miss Peterson dan King? Siapa yang mau? Kita punya waktu 3 menit.
Destri, sir.
Destri lagi. Yang lain. Tadi Destri udah.
Ya, sir.
Siapa?
Nggak nampak.
Coba, sir.
Siapa? Mau coba?
Ya, sir.
Elona? Bukan?
Irsyad, sir.
Oh, Irsyad. Oke, okay. Irsyad Atul Ardi. 3 menit waktu kita ya. Sama yang menjadi king siapa?
Ya, sir.
Irsyad dan?
Tia.
Oh, Tia. Oke, okay, Tia. Silakan. Saya baca dulu pertama ini ya, yang dialognya ini. Would you mind if I looked at your resume? King Zhang was trained as a computer programmer in China, so she'd like a job in the same field here in the USA. There's a lot of competition for computer programming positions, but King is well qualified. Let's listen to an interview between King and the director of human resources at a major telecommunications company. Okay, silakan. Oke, okay, silakan. Irsyad, yang Miss Peterson adalah Irsyadatul, and King Tia Rahma. Oke, okay, silakan.
Hello, Miss Song. I'm Maria Peterson. Have a seat, please.
Thank you.
Miss Peterson, would you like some? Mrs. Peterson, would you like something to drink? Coffee? Tea, water?
Yeah, yes, I'd like some water, please. Thank you.
Would you mind if I look at your resume?
Of course not. Here is it.
Well, now I'd like to know a little bit more about your background. How long have you been here? When do you study? You do have a green card, don't you? Yes, here it is. I see it. Wait. Salah, Pak. Of course, huh? Not here it is. This person. Oh, yeah. Yeah, benar seperti. Well, now I'd like to know a little bit more about your background. How long have you been here? Where did you study? You do have a green card, don't you? Yes, here it is. I see it here on your resume. And what would you like to do here at Qualcomm Communications?
I've been here for about 3 weeks, maybe a little over 3 weeks. I used to live in Massachusetts before I came here.
Okay, all right. We will continue after this. We have limited time. Kita lanjutkan nanti di sesi kedua. It's less than 1 minute. Okay? I'll see you in session 2. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.